Okay, good afternoon, you guys. Welcome back. If you joined us for mindfulness this morning, thanks for returning. For those of you that are new to this class or have never seen it before, this is our afternoon class. We've been offering it the last couple of weeks. It's rehabilitative strengthening. So we're focusing a little bit more on strength and endurance with this class. So more reps, maybe a little bit more resistance, faster pace. That being said, we want to make sure that everything you do while doing this class, you stay safe, right? So everything I'm going to offer and show and suggest is just that. It's a suggestion. Everything is chair-based, but you can feel free to modify as long as you are staying safe, staying stable, and avoiding pain. So whatever you guys do, make sure that you're listening to your body, make sure you're tuning in to your needs. And that can vary, right? How you felt yesterday might be a little different than how you feel today. So really make sure you are observing yourself, watching your breath, keeping an eye on heart rate, even your body temperature. Right, all of those things might change with increased activity, but you still want to make sure they're within reason and that you're staying safe. So that being said, though, we just want to have a little bit of fun with it. We're going to move a little bit, might even sweat a little bit. We'll have some music going, and hopefully, you guys enjoy this. So, I always like to have a tidbit or a quote or something about movement and health and physical activity. This one today, I'll go ahead and read. It says, when it comes to health and well-being, regular exercise is about as close to a magic potion as you can get. When it comes to health and well-being, regular exercise is about as close to a magic potion as you can get. And it just kind of reminds us there is no magic potion, right? There's no magic pill, there's no wave of the wand, and all of a sudden we're gonna be super fit or 100% healthy. We still have to put in the work. But that being said, that work can be regular activity, right? If we're taking a daily walk, if we're doing our daily chair activities, even a little bit of breath work or just some sit to stands, if you're working on strengthening your legs and your glutes, getting that core engaged, right? There's a lot of different ways that regular exercise can look, and it's gonna vary. It's gonna vary depending on the person, right? What capabilities and strength do you already come to the table with? And that's always different for each person, and that's okay. You know, we don't all have to be bodybuilders and marathoners, is the example I give. Getting our hands over our head might be our activity for the day. Working on facial exercises or eye exercises might be our regular activity for the day. Standing up, you know, once every hour might be that regular activity. So just know whatever it is for you. Again, it's going to be a little different, but that's okay. Understand what's best for your body. Make sure you're listening to your body. And make it a daily practice, right? It's something we're always working at, we're always striving for, but we also want the process to be fun. So that's where hopefully the music comes in, the chair activities, and all the strengthening exercises we're about to do come in. So join along with us. We're gonna head to the starting position. Hope you guys have some fun, stay safe, and we'll start to get moving. Thanks. All right, you guys. So the music we have today, we've got a little Johnny Cash playlist. We're gonna get going. So we'll see what happens with that. We'll see what kind of music comes out. Go ahead, come to your starting position. We always like to begin with feet flat on the floor, hips heavy. Feel a nice stable base. You want to feel grounded through all of this activity, but then create some length and buoyancy with your spine, right? Feel your core active. Feel that spine get a little taller, sit up nice and tall here. And just as we do with all movement, we'll go ahead and start with a couple deep breaths. So really allow these to be strong, cleansing breaths, clearing out anything you don't need. So go ahead, inhale through the nose, pull the breath in, open mouth, exhale, let it go. Good, nice deep cleansing breath in, Exhale, open the mouth, let it all go. Last one, deep breath in. Open mouth, exhale, let it go. So, so good, you guys. Continue to keep that breath moving through all of the activity. At any point, if you need to slow down, take a break, check in with your vitals, please, please do so. We want to make sure, again, that your safety and your health are top priority. Also, one more PSA, make sure you got some water by your side. You want to stay hydrated, right? So whether that's taking a sip before or if you have an alternate version of that, make sure that you're checking in. As we start to move our body more, we might get a little warm, a little dehydrated. So make sure that you stay filled up, okay? So cheers to that. We'll go ahead and get started with this playlist. Whoops, let's see. Here we go. We got a little Pretty Woman, Roy Orbison starting this off. So go ahead, get to that beginning position. We're gonna get our spine warmed up here first. We'll start by dropping the chin and lifting it up. We'll start to get that neck active and engaged. Maybe tap the toe a little bit to the beat of the song. And at any point, if you want to stop exercising and just start dancing, feel free. This next hour is totally your time. Good. Keep that breath going, guys. Nice. I'm always aiming for about 10 reps, but for anyone that's watched those videos or tried to keep count, you know I can never keep track, so that's our goal. We'll just kind of go until we feel good. Nice. Get that neck moving. Make sure it feels good in your body. Nice job, you guys. One more each direction. Take it down, take it up, and come on back to center. Awesome work, you guys. So coming back to that starting position, keeping the spine nice and long, we're now going to take the spine in lateral flexion. So that's going to be dropping the ear to one shoulder and then switching and going to the opposite. So go ahead and just start to move side to side here. Good. Keep that breath moving as we start to increase the pace. Elevate the speed a little bit. Our bodies are going to require more oxygen. Those muscles need it to keep moving. Keep that blood flow going. Nice work, you guys. And I don't know about you, but if you're not picturing Julia Roberts and Richard Gere, did you even see the movie? I don't know. Is she walking down Rodeo Drive, buying all her fancy clothes? Alright, guys, keep it going. Make sure you're moving at your pace, right? If you need to speed it up or slow it down, do what's best for your body. Let's go ahead. One more each side. Take it right, take it left, and come on back to center. Ha! So, so good, you guys. All right, so now we're going to do some shoulder rolls here. So this is going to start to loosen up the shoulder girdle, relieve a little tension in the neck here. So let's begin. Bring those shoulders up to the ears and back down again. Up to the ears and back down again. Nice work, you guys. Start to get that going. Get the breath flowing. Maybe if you've gone halfway in one direction, switch direction, go the other way.
2 hours of pushing
brooms.
8 by 12 4-bit room.
Nice job, you guys. Think about activating those muscles both as you pull up and as you draw the shoulders down. Nice work. Getting everything warmed up here. All right, come on back to that starting position. Again, we're going to return with our feet flat, keep the spine nice and long. Now, this next one, we want to have our arms nice and heavy down by our sides. Maybe you relax your hands here in the laps. And what we're going to focus on is engaging all the muscles in the front of our body here. So it's essentially like doing a seated crunch. But we really want to round everything forward, pulling in the abdomen, pulling in the chest muscles, squeezing the pecs here, maybe even getting that neck and throat involved, right? So rounding everything forward, and then coming back to seated. Nice. Now, if you feel a stretch in the back of your body, that's okay. That's just going to be a reciprocal action that happens. And as long as there's no pain, that's totally fine. But let's go ahead, keep pulling everything forward, get those muscles active. Feel them tightening, squeezing in towards the front of your body. Nice job, you guys. Keep it going here. Maybe pairing the motion with breath and just checking in. How does it feel in your body? Is your breath still smooth and steady? Can you feel those muscles engaged? Nice job, you guys. Doing so, so good here. Awesome work. Let's go ahead and do one more here. Pull all those muscles together. And then come on back to seated. Woo! Nice job, you guys. Return to that starting position. The next motion we're going to do is focusing on the muscles on the back of our body. So if you have armrests, you can place your hands right on those. And then what we're going to want to do is focus on squeezing the muscles behind us. Now, if you want, you can place your hands here at the base of your chair, or even behind you on the back of the chair. And then as we breathe, squeeze all those muscles here. Feel your shoulder blades engaged. Feel the whole length of the spine curl in towards itself. Good, and then relax. Nice, squeeze those muscles, engage everything in the backside, maybe even drop your head back a little, and relax. Nice work, you guys. Let's keep it going. Turn that up just a little bit. Good. Got some Alabama for ya. Feel those muscles engaged. Feel your spine wrapping towards itself. Feel all the way from your tailbone up to the base of your head. Good. Keep the breath moving. Again, if the front of the body stretches open, that's okay. It's just a reciprocal action of trying to engage the entire backside of your body. Nice work, you guys. Keep the breath moving, get the blood flowing, get the oxygen to those muscles. Nice job. Let's do one more here. Pull all those muscles in. Engage, engage, engage. And relax. Woo. Nice job, you guys. Way to start it off strong. Let's go ahead and take a nice deep breath to reset. Inhale through the nose. Open mouth, exhale, let it go. So good. All right, I'm going to take a water break here. Feel free to do the same. Make sure you check in with yourself. Again, if you don't want to do any of the exercises and you just want to move your body, dance to the music, any motion should be good motion as long as there's no pain and that you stay safe and stable. All right, let's go ahead and move on to the rest of our arms here. So we're going to work our way from our shoulders down to our elbows, wrists, and even out the fingers. So for this first one, we're going to start with flexion and extension at the shoulders. So that's essentially flexion up, extension back down. Good. And so what we want to do here is you have a couple options with your hands. You can either take fingers in between one another. You can take a cupped grip like this. You can utilize the strength of one hand to assist the other. Or you can do all of this with one hand. So find whatever feels best in your body. Come to that starting position. And then we'll start to flex as we lift those arms up. And extend as we drop them down. Good. Flexion as we go forward. Extension back and down. Nice job, you guys. Keep that breath moving, smooth and steady. Also know that it doesn't matter the height that you take your arms to. Maybe you just come to shoulder height and back down. Shoulder height and back down. Maybe you're just lifting up off your lap here and back down. That's okay. Wherever you need to be, just focus on that. Focus on engaging the muscles, activating them around the shoulders. And keep the breath moving, of course. Nice job, you guys. All right, let's go ahead and do one more here. And when you get to the top, we're going to stay there as high as you can go. And then move a little side to side. Good. So start to get the core engaged a little bit here. Get a little bit more mobility in the shoulders, in the shoulder girdle. If your hands are a little lower and you're right at shoulder height, that's okay. You can still go side to side. Even if they're lower down towards the left, right? Lots of different modifications here for you. Nice job, you guys. Wherever you're at, take another deep breath. And then exhale, release those arms down. Let them settle. Awesome, awesome work, you guys. You are doing so good. All right, so we are going to move on to flexion of the elbow and then extension of the elbow. So flexion is pulling that hand up in towards your shoulder. Extension is straightening that arm out. Right, so it's essentially a bicep curl, but we have a couple options with it. Same with the hand grip, right? So fingers in between, cupped position, using one hand to assist the other, or just raising one arm. So I'm going to turn to the side so that you can see a different view of this. And again, come to that starting position, take your hand grip, and then bending at the elbows, straightening them back down. Bending at the elbows, straightening them back down. Nice job, you guys. Keep the breath moving. If the breath's not moving, none of this can happen. Good. I always had a yoga teacher tell us, if you don't think the breath is important, try not breathing for a minute or two. You'll quickly learn how important the breath is. Luckily, we normally can breathe without thinking about it. However, we don't want to take it for granted. So make sure that you're focusing on the breath. Nice inhales in, smooth exhales out. Good. Wherever you're at, doing one hand or both. Nice job, you guys. Keep the breath moving here. Nice work. All right. Bill, if you're out there, you know we're probably at about 45. This is where I need him keeping me on track, counting. All right, let's do one more good one here. Squeeze those muscles in, focus on the biceps, and then straighten them out, focusing on the triceps. Nice, nice job, you guys. You are doing so good. All right, I'm going to take a quick sip of water. And then I'm going to come in a little closer to you here so I can show you the rest of the hand exercises. All right, you guys. Hopefully you're doing great. Oh, this is Patsy Cline. This is one of my favorites. This always reminds me of my mama. All right, so moving on from Patsy. We're now going to focus here on our forearms, okay? So the motion here is pronation, which is palm down, supination, which is palm up. Pronation, palm down, supination is palm up. Now, if you can know, or if you can tell, I'm just moving at the forearm, right? My shoulder's not getting involved. That's just stay nice and stable down by the body. It's truly just a rotation here at the forearm. Feels like the wrist is rotating. So you can either do that with one hand. You can use the other hand to assist, right? If you're trying to do an active assist with yourself. And then of course, if you've got the hand grip options, right? So you're either fingers in between or cupped over one another, and same thing. You're just rotating those forearms over one another. I want to start singing, but I'm not going to torture you guys. This is one of those good songs to sing in the car, the shower, right? When you know you're your only audience. Nice job, you guys. I can hum. I'll hum a little bit. I just won't sing. Nice work, you guys. Keep focusing on those forearm muscles. Good. Keep that breath moving. And then we'll go ahead and release. Let it go. If you need to, shake out the hands. You can always come in, massage those muscles a little bit, right? If you need to loosen them up or give them a little rest here. Good. Okay, so now we're going to move on and we're going to focus just on our wrist here. So what we're doing is flexion, which is forward, and then extension, which is back, right? So flexion forward, extension back. Good. So you're engaging the muscles again, still in the forearm and the wrist here, right? Just working at the joint and then back. Same thing, this side of the forearm. So you're not getting the shoulder or the elbow involved. It's just at the wrist. Good. If you're using your other hand to assist, right, maybe pull that wrist in, push it back, pull that wrist in, push it back. Good. And then, of course, back to the other hand grip options. Nice job, you guys. Keep the breath moving. Good. Dirty shirt. Nice job, you guys. All right, go ahead, shake that out. We are all done with the wrist action. All right, so we're going to move on now. Now we're going to get into some of our fingers, or all of our fingers, I should say, but some finger actions here. So this first one is called opposition. It's essentially taking the thumb pad and pushing it against the pads of every other finger. Right, so we'll start with our pinky. So you're gonna push the thumb into the pinky and then let go. Push it into the ring finger and let go. Middle finger and let go. Pointer finger and let go. Nice. Now you really want to try and focus on getting those finger pads into each other and using all the strength of the hand and the fingers, tiny little muscles, but you want to try and engage them as much as you can. All right, so we just did pinky, now we're on to ring. Then we go to middle finger. So you should start to feel those hands working overtime, right? Good. Then the pointer finger. Nice. Now, if your hand is unable to open up fully, like I'm showing you, and you just want to focus on the base of each finger, you can do that as well. So you can use your other hand to come in and draw the pinky and the thumb towards one another, working at the base, right? And then maybe the ring finger, open up, then moving into the middle finger, right? See, I'm taking the base of those fingers towards one another. Good, and then pointer finger. Nice job, you guys. Also, if you just need a little assistance coming in at the tips of the fingers, right? Then letting go. Middle, ring finger, releasing. Middle finger, releasing. And pointer finger, and releasing. Nice job, you guys. Of course, if you're using both hands, it's gonna look no different, just the same thing. Pinky finger and release. Ring finger and release. Middle finger and release. Pointer finger and release. Ha, nice job, you guys. So good. Again, feel free to shake it out. Maybe massage the hand a little bit. Sometimes those tinier muscles, you can really start to work you, right? You don't even notice, they just creep up on you. Feel free to shake it out. Give those hands and those fingers a reset. All right, moving right along, you guys. You're doing so good today. So let's go ahead and finish up all the fingers and hand stuff. And we're gonna do that by clenching our fists, right? So pulling everything in here, tight, 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 and then opening up as wide as you can go. Tight. Opening up as wide as it will go. Good. Nice job, you guys. So what you're doing here is flexing all the fingers in, flexing the hands, squeezing it all in, and then extending by lengthening through those hands, straightening them out again. Nice. Now again, if you're just using one hand, it's gonna look no different. If you're using one hand to assist, right, you can help push it open and then curl it back in. Help open it up and then curl it back in. Nice job, you guys. Keep the breath moving wherever you're at. These might be smaller motions, but they require just as much oxygen, right? Nice job. All right, you guys, go ahead. One more here. So we're gonna tighten, clench those fists, hold on real, real tight, and then open as far as you can. So good. Nice job, you guys. Shake out those hands. Give them a little rest, maybe a little massage. I am going to head back to our starting position in the chair over there. We'll take a sip of water, we'll reset, and then we'll start with legs and core. All right, you guys, go ahead. Take a sip of water here. And let's actually go ahead and take a breath to reset as well. So inhale through the nose. Open mouth, exhale, let it go. Awesome work, you guys. All right, so these next several are going to be focusing on our core and our legs here. So here's a really good opportunity to see that even if you're seated, right, even if you spend most of your day sitting in a chair, you can still be active. You can still do regular exercise even from the chair. Right, so if I'm lying all the way back and just kind of slouching here, none of my muscles are being used, my core is very relaxed, nothing's engaged. The minute I sit up, lift my spine, lengthen through the top of my head, feel my core activate, feel the spinal muscles engage, this right here is already activating my muscles. And it's going to require a little bit more work than just being lounged in the chair. Right? So this is your starting position. And this right here is perfect. If this is what you're working on, be here, be present, and try to get stronger in this position. Everything else we add is going to be a bonus. So this first one that we're focusing on will be the thighs. So with an active spine, core engaged, whole trunk lifted, we're going to start by squeezing our thighs here and straightening those legs. Good. We're going to alternate as well. So squeeze, tighten those thighs, straighten that leg, and then release. Good. We're extending as we straighten and flexing as we come back. Nice job, you guys. And then, of course, keep that breath moving. As we start to get in the bigger muscles of the body, you might feel the need to breathe a little bit more, breathe a little deeper. That's okay. The bigger muscles require a little bit more oxygen. And so we really want to keep that breath flowing smooth and steady. Nice. Keep your low belly active here. Nice job, guys. A couple more just like this. Really feel those muscles activated. Let's do one more each side. Squeeze. Relax. And then last leg, squeeze the thigh and relax. Nice job, you guys, doing so good. I meant to tell you, and I don't think I did with that one, if at any point you need to give your spine a little rest and a little support, you can lay it back on the back of the chair, but you still want to keep those muscles activated. So keep that in mind when we do this next one. We are going to turn it up a little bit here. So starting with that active core, we're going to straighten one leg. And then we're going to start by making big circles with the leg here. Good. If it feels okay, you can get that ankle involved if that's available. And this is where, if you need to, go ahead and lean back a little bit. But keep that chest lifted, keep that spine lifted, and keep the low belly engaged, right? Even if you're getting support here from the chair, You still want those muscles working. Good. Go ahead, make sure you take a break with that leg because we're going to come back with another set of that on the same leg, just different rotation. All right, so now we're going to reverse the rotation. My core is still active, spine is long. If the weight of my leg is a little too heavy, I can bend the knee here and then continue to make big circles with the hip, okay? So a couple other options. Keep the breath moving. Nice job, you guys. Good. Take another breath here. Ah, go ahead, rest that leg down. You guys are doing awesome. You look great out there. So we're gonna go ahead, do the same thing on the other leg. Have that core engaged, spine is long and lifted, straighten the left leg, and then let's start to make big circles. Good, if it feels okay, get the ankle involved, really focusing on the motion here at the hip. Again, if the weight of the leg is too heavy, you can bend the knee. That just lightens the load, I should say. Good, and when you're ready, take a rest here with that leg. Give it a second to breathe, because then we're gonna do one more set on that same side, just reverse the direction. So straighten the leg here again, and then go in the opposite direction. Nice. Again, if you need a little support, you can lean back here. Keeping the spine active, keeping the abs engaged. Nice job, you guys. Wherever you're at, keep breathing, keep moving, doing the best that you can in this moment. Nice work. Go ahead, relax that leg down. Good work. So we're actually going to give our bigger muscles a rest here. I'm going to turn to the side to show you what we're going to be doing here. We're going to get into our feet, our calves, do a little heel raises. So I'm going to be here, seated, knees bent, feet are flat, and the goal here is to push our toes down into the floor while we lift those heels up. Good, and then rest. Good, push the toes into the floor while you lift the heels, and then rest. Nice job, you guys. So we're activating our calf muscles, activating the muscles of our feet. And release. Nice work, you guys. Couple options, of course, if you want to alternate and do one at a time. Good. Maybe you're focusing on just one foot. And then if you want a little bit more of a challenge, whether you do one leg or both, you can actually add a little resistance here. So you're going to take the strength of your arms and the strength of your core and push into your knees here, right? So you're adding resistance against the knees while you lift those heels up. So you're essentially fighting body weight with body weight here. Good. So you should feel your core engaged, your upper body engaged, and then you should feel it a little harder to lift those heels with the full weight of your upper body up top. Nice. Maybe you're just doing one side. Nice work, you guys. Wherever you're at, keep the breath moving. You guys are doing so good. Nice work. All right. I know, Bill, we're probably at like 52, so let's do a couple more. And we'll go ahead and wrap up here, you guys. Nice job. I'm going to go ahead and come back to center. Ha, we're doing so good. Okay, let's do a little time check real quick. Perfect, we're moving along. I'm going to do a quick sip of water. All right, these next three are definitely going to turn up the temperature here. It's okay if you start sweating. It's okay if your heart rate raises a little bit, but make sure it stays in check. If you get dizzy or a little lightheaded or too warm, slow it down, take a couple of breaths, maybe even stop. Always have the option of having a sip of water. Just make sure you tune in to how your body is feeling. And don't push it, right? There's a fine line between challenging yourself and overdoing it. So only you know that difference. Just make sure you're keeping an eye out for that. All right, this next one, we come back to our starting position. We engage the core, sit up nice and tall. And we're going to start with marches here. So lifting each leg up towards the ceiling and then alternating. Nice job. Keep that low belly active. You should feel this in the abdominals as well as the thighs here. Spine is long and lifted. If you need a little support, you can hold on to the chair beneath you. You can always lean back and support the spine with the back of the chair, but just keep that belly active. Nice job. If you want a little bit more of a balanced challenge, bring your arms out, right? Or move them up or something. Anything away from the side of the body is going to challenge you here a little bit more.
It seems like yesterday.
Nice job, you guys. Doing so good. Keep that breath moving. We're using the bigger muscles here. Nice job. All right, one more each side. And done. So good, you guys. You are doing great. All right, this next one I'm going to turn to the side so you can see the full expression. These are called core holds. So the point here is to engage our entire core. That's both front and back, right? So when people talk about core, you normally think, oh, six pack or all your abs. But your core is really your whole trunk. So front, side, back, all the muscles from top to bottom, right? So what we're going to do here is lift the arms up, activate the belly muscles as well as the back muscles. I want to keep it nice and straight, no slouching. Try not to pull it too far forward, right? Good neutral spine here, engaged. And then we're going to lift the legs. Good. And a couple options with the height of the legs, right? If you need to keep them a little lower, if you want to bend the knees, or if you just keep them straight out in front of you. Good. And then, of course, several variations here. Maybe you just do one leg, right? Have this one supporting. Lift that leg, maybe it even comes a little higher. Keep that spine long, low belly active, and the breath moving. Nice job, you guys. Maybe you switch up the legs. Also, you have the option of bringing your hands to the seat beneath you and then lifting the legs, right? So you're supporting your arms a little bit more and then activating the core and the legs. Keep the breath moving. Last option, of course, you can take your back all the way to the back of the chair and then lift the legs. Right, so bottom of the feet shines straight out. Your core is still active and engaged, but it's supported slightly here by the chair. Nice job, you guys. Keep the breath moving. I'll turn to the side one more and show full expression. Arms out, legs up, core active here. Feel my spine nice and long, all the muscles working together. Now you can either do holds like this, right? So 3 seconds, 5 seconds, 10 seconds. Or we can do reps, right? Bringing those legs up. Make sure there's no weight or pain in the low back here. Good, and then the breath stays moving. Nice job, you guys. Go ahead, come on down. Give those abs and that spine a little bit of a rest. Awesome, awesome job. All right, we are moving on to our last leg and core exercise. So we will start from the core hold position, okay? So again, we want to keep that spine long, lifted, feel your chest elevate, and then feel all the muscles active all the way around the spine here. Arms come up, and then the legs start to pedal like you're on a bicycle. So you're adding a little bit of movement here to the lower extremities. Feeling your abs and your tummy tighten here. Feel your spine long and lifted. And keep that breath moving. Nice job. Couple options, of course, right? You can do one leg at a time. Good. And then you can, of course, use your arms down here on the chair. Give your upper body a little bit more support while keeping the legs going. And then, of course, final option is to have your whole spine supported while your legs move. Again, all of this, you could just say, the heck with it, start dancing, totally your call. Nice job, you guys. I'll turn to the side one more time, show full expression. Good. Maybe you're sweating a little bit, maybe the temperature rises, heart rate might increase, that's all okay. Keep it in check, make sure you're feeling okay. Good, take a deep breath in. And slowly let it go. Woo. Nice, nice job, you guys. You did so good. Let's go ahead and take a breath here to reset. Inhale through the nose. Open mouth, exhale, let it go. Awesome. I'm going to go ahead and take a sip of water. You guys should do the same. Okay. How are we doing? Very, very good. Okay, moving right along. So we are done with the larger muscles of the body. And now we're going to start to get into some of the smaller muscles of the face. So we'll have both eye and mouth exercises. So with the eye exercises, the rule of thumb is to always have the eyes follow the thumb, right? So if the thumb is moving, the eyes move. The thumb is still, the eyes are still. I'll go ahead and walk you through all of these, but first we'll bring our thumb straight out in front. Lock your eyes on the thumb, and then keeping your head right where it's at, start to make big circles with the thumb. Only the eyes follow. The head stays perfectly still, but we're moving the eyes around in their sockets. Try to get as far to the edges as your eyes will go while keeping your head perfectly still. Nice job, you guys. Keep that breath moving. Smooth and steady. Good. Let's do a couple more. And then when we rest, we'll bring our thumb in and close the eyes. So come on, bring your thumb back to center, close the eyes, and rest the hand. Good. So resting the eyes is very, very important, right? No different than when we take breaks in between our bicep curls or our bicycles. We have to give the eye muscles an opportunity to rest and reset. Because guess what? We're going to do the exact same thing, except take the thumb in a different direction, right? So we're just going to reverse the rotation. So again, eyes stick to thumb. Go ahead, bring that thumb straight out in front. Open the eyes. Head stays still. And now go ahead and go in opposite direction. Good.
One of the brothers was a bad outlaw.
Nice job, you guys. Take that thumb, moving it in all directions here. Keep the breath moving. Take those eyes as far as they'll go.
He had the nerve and he had the blood. Never was a horse like the
Tennessee. Nice job, you guys. Let's do one more big one all the way around. Then bring that thumb back to center, close the eyes, and release the thumb. Ah, so, so good, you guys. You are doing great. Really important to give those eyes a break here, right? Those muscles, they might be tiny, and we might not think to normally work them out, but we wouldn't be able to look side to side, up, down, and all around if we didn't strengthen those eye muscles. All right, so these next two, it's going to be similar, but a little different. We're going to keep the thumb and the eye steady and move the head around the eyeballs. So go ahead, bring that thumb straight out, open the eyes, This time we're going to shake our head side to side, but the eyes stay steady on the thumb. Good. So the head moves from left to right and back again, but the eyes do not move off that thumb. Nice. Try to get all the way to the corners of the eyes here. Nice job, you guys. Feel free to blink, of course. You don't need to keep your eyes open the whole time. Nice job. One more each side. Go right and left. Come back to center. Close the eyes and release. Ah, nice, nice job, you guys. Doing so good. All right, we've got one more for the eye exercises. We'll do something similar to the last one, except we're going to take the head up and down. So let's go ahead. Bring that thumb straight out. Open the eyes. Eyes stay on the thumb. Draw that chin up. Draw that chin down. Good. Again, eyes stay steady, but the head moves around the eyes. Try to take them all the way down and all the way up. Nice job, you guys. Keep the breath moving. If you love eye muscles are no different. They need oxygen to operate. Good. Couple more. You guys are doing great. One more each direction. Up and then down. Back to center, close the eyes and release. Woo! Maybe shake out that arm, release the thumb a little bit. With your eyes closed, let's take a breath to reset. Inhale through the nose. Open mouth, exhale, let it go. Nice work, you guys. Go ahead, open those eyes back up. I'm gonna get another sip of water. Feel free to bring the water with you. I'm gonna come up close to you guys and we'll finish off with mouth exercises.
If you tell me that she's not here, I'll follow
the trail. All right, how are you guys doing out there? We are almost finished and you are doing fantastic. So let's go ahead. Just like we might massage our neck or loosen up our calf or our forearm, we're going to do that with our jaw muscles, right? So get into the cheeks, the mouth, maybe right around the ears. Good. Just start to loosen those muscles up, release any tension. Nice job, you guys. All right, so no different. Bicep curls, core holds, marches, hand exercises. Our mouth muscles are equally, if not more, important, right? Chewing, talking, swallowing, all the essentials to living here. So we will do our exercises and then we'll be done. You guys are doing so good. All right, this first one, we're just gonna open the mouth as wide as it'll go, right? So wide, 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 open up and then close. Good, so really try to pull that jaw away from the top of your mouth. And close. Good. We'll do about 10 of these each.
Thank you for your precious time. Forgive me if I
nice job, you guys. You're over halfway there. Keep it going. Open big and close. Last one. Make it a good one. Nice and big and close. So good, you guys. You're doing awesome. Feel free at any point to take a break. Again, massage those cheeks. Just kind of loosen up those muscles. All right, so the next one that we're going to do is always my favorite. We're just going to smile nice and big, right? So we'll go ahead, take those cheeks, take the corners of the mouth up into the cheeks, and then relax. Good. Pull that mouth up. And relax. Keep it going, you guys. Pull the corners away here. Nice big. Show those teeth. Relax. Nice job, you guys. One more big one. And relax. Nice job. You guys are doing awesome. Okay, so we're going to do a couple more smiles here, but we're going to alternate them with puckers, like you're going to kiss someone, right? So go ahead, take those smiles back. Feel the muscles pulling up and back into your cheeks, and then push everything forward and make a big pucker. Kissing noise is optional, right? Pull them back, push them forward. Nice job, you guys. Keep it going. Good. Couple more. You're doing so good. One last one. Pull those muscles back and push those lips forward. Good, you guys. So, so awesome. All right, this next one, I will describe it first and then show you. We're gonna seal our lips here and then puff our cheeks up like a blowfish, right? Once the air is in our cheeks, keeping the lips sealed, we're gonna try and push that air pressure from side to side. Now the goal here is to not let any air come out those lips. A little might slip, but that's okay. That's when you know you gotta seal them a little tighter. So it looks like this. Good. You might have heard a little air sneak out of my lips there. That's okay. I'll just know for next time. Now, also, if you're doing this with one hand, it'll look like this. Nice, nice job, you guys. You're doing so good. Let's finish off with one more for this set. Blow those cheeks up, keep those lips sealed, and then push the air side to side. Nice job, you guys. You're doing awesome. All right. This next one, lip smacks. So I always have to wet my lips a little bit here, but we want to seal those lips nice and tight and then smack wide open. Let's go ahead and do about 10 of those. Let's do one more big one. Make it nice and loud. Nice job, you guys. Awesome, awesome work. All right, just a couple more left to go. These next two, we're gonna focus on the tongue. So the point here is to keep the tongue action slow and controlled. So we're gonna take this side to side from the corner of one mouth, or one corner of the mouth to the other, right? Nice. Now, if you want to speed it up, you can, but if you start to speed it up and your tongue goes in different directions, slow it down. No shame in going slower as long as it's controlled. All right. Sorry, guys. My video, something popped up there. So we'll just go ahead and keep moving on. All right. So this next one, we want to make our tongue go up and down, right? Good. And again, same thing. If you can go a little faster, but keep it controlled, by all means do so. I can't really go fast going up and down, so I'm going to keep mine slow and controlled. Awesome. Doing so, so good. Okay. So this next one is always a little challenging. So I'm going to take a sip of water first. We're going to go ahead, and what we want to do is gently bite the tongue here. So keep it clamped in between the teeth. And then while holding on to the tongue with the teeth, swallow. Good. So this one can definitely be a little bit more tricky. So feel free to take breaks. Feel free to have a sip of water and just do what you can. Nice job, you guys. You're doing so good with this. Keep it up. Nice job. Let's go ahead, finish off. Let's do one more. Nice work. So, so good. All right. This final one, we are almost done, you guys. We're doing great. We're going to alternate between frowning and swallowing. So it'll look like this. Good. And if you need to use your hand to assist with that frown, that's okay. Maybe it's just on one side, maybe it's both. Just gently drawing the corners of the mouth down, right? All right, you guys, one more. Let's make this a good one. Whew, all right, I'm going to take a sip of water. We made it through that. You guys did so, so good. As always, let's go ahead and finish off our exercises with a couple cleansing breaths here. Let's really move any of that heat, release anything we don't need. Take a nice deep breath in. Open mouth, exhale, let it go. Inhale, deep breath in. Exhale, open mouth, let it go. And last one, cleansing, cleansing breath in. Exhale, open mouth, let it go. Thank you guys so, so much for joining. You did awesome. We made it through the whole hour. You did so good. I hope you guys have a wonderful rest of your day. We will be back again tomorrow, 10 a.m. for our morning mindfulness, 1:30 for our rehabilitative strengthening. We hope we see you for one or both of those. Either way, have a wonderful rest of your day, and we'll see you guys again soon. Thanks so much.